Today we're looking at the Minisforum AtomMan G7 Ti, compact, powerful and packed with Intel Core i9, Nvidia RTX 4070 and 32GB of DDR5 RAM. On paper it's a 4K gaming machine, but is it just for gamers? Well, I couldn't find clear answers about its performance for creative tasks like video editing, I bought one to see for myself. I wanted to see if it could handle more like 4K video editing, multitasking and even replace a PS5 or Xbox Series X for gaming. Can this mini PC deliver top tier performance across the board? Subscribe if you're ready and let's find out what the G7 Ti is really made of. Inside this big box we got the PC itself, a manual, a power adapter, extra screws and a stand. It's not your typical bare bones unit, this one comes fully loaded. The bare bones option lets you swap out RAM and storage for savings if you got parts lying around, but we're focusing on the fully loaded version today. You'll need a small Phillips screwdriver for the stand, but once that's in place, you're good to go. That stand isn't just for looks, it's designed to optimize airflow and cooling, which is crucial for keeping things running smoothly and at peak performance. When it comes to design, the G7 Ti hits that sweet spot between sleek and practical. The aluminium chassis is clean and minimalist, with ventilation holes that keep temperatures in check. The overall vibe is kind of monitor-less laptop, a bit like PS5, but with serious power under the hood. On the front, you've got your basics power button, a gaming mode toggle, an RGB light strip you can customize, and two USB 3 ports. Around back, you'll find USB-C 4.0, HDMI 2.1 that supports 8K at 60Hz, a 5G Ethernet port, and plenty of cooling vents. However, while the USB-C doubling as a display port for multi-monitor setups is great, it's missing a dedicated display port entirely. For gamers or creators who prefer high refresh rate 2K or 4K displays, this could mean investing in some adapters. Also, there are only a handful of USB ports here, which might feel limiting if you're plugging in multiple peripherals like external drives, controllers or a webcam. So if you're that person, maybe grab a good USB hub. The G7 Ti comes in two versions, a fully loaded option with an Intel i9-14900HX, 32GB of RAM and a 1TB SSD, and a bare-bones option for custom setups. There's also the special edition featuring an i7 processor and the budget-friendly G7 PT variant. At its heart, the i9-14900HX is a 24-core, 32-thread powerhouse with a max clock speed at 5.8 GHz. It's been built for intensive tasks like 4K editing, 3D rendering and gaming. Pairing this CPU with the mobile RTX 4070, which boasts 4608 CUDA cores and 8GB of GDDR6, makes it a strong contender for AAA games and creative applications. However, mobile GPUs have inherent thermal and power limitations compared to their desktop counterparts. For tasks like 3D rendering or AI workloads, the GPU performs admirably but is best suited to optimized workflows. Storage includes dual PCIe 4.0 M.2 slots for fast file access and potential upgrades. The system's 32GB of DDR5 RAM is upgradable to 96GB, sufficient for most professionals, though users with large-scale AI or rendering projects might find the upper limit restrictive compared to the desktop PCs. Connectivity is cutting edge, with Wi-Fi 7 and Bluetooth 5.4 ensuring reliable networking for online gaming and cloud-based collaborations. Finally, gamers will enjoy low latency and high refresh rates, while professionals with multi-display setups will appreciate the HDMI and USB-C ports. If more displays are needed, I would recommend a Thunderbolt dock. Now, let's talk gaming. The G7 Ti doesn't just handle games, it dominates them, setting a new bar for compact PCs. I started with Forza Horizon 5 on my 4K TV at ultra settings. While it held a rock-solid 60fps, the TV's 60Hz refresh rate was a bottleneck. Cranking it up to extreme settings triggered a mild graphic memory warning, but performance stayed impressively stable. To unlock its full potential, I upgraded to a 27-inch 2K monitor with a 180Hz refresh rate, roughly the same size as my iMac. The difference? Night and day. At 2K resolution on extreme settings, Forza Horizon 5 averaged at 108 frames per second, occasionally dipping to 80 to 90 FPS in visually dense scenes. Smooth, responsive, and visually stunning. Next up, Starfield. At ultra settings, this PC delivered 144 FPS, even during action-packed space battles and planetary exploration. For reference, my previous review on the Minisforum UM770 Slim showed Mafia Definite Edition struggling to hit 11 FPS in 4K. On the G7 Ti, the same game runs butter smooth at 80 FPS. The leap in performance is staggering. Other games like Assassin's Creed Valhalla ran at 120 to 140 FPS on ultra settings with every visual enhancement cranked up. All the titles like Assassin's Creed Origins and Shadow of War, flawless. So, should you choose 4K or 2K? On a 27-inch monitor, the visual difference is minimal, but 2K delivers higher refresh rate, making it a better choice for fast-paced gaming. For larger display, 4K is still compelling, though you'll trade off a few frames. Content creators, take note, this PC is a beast for editing. Testing DaVinci Resolve with multiple 4K video and audio tracks, heavy transitions and advanced color grading, the timeline remained buttery smooth and export times were impressively fast. The RTX 4070 skewed the course, handled real-time effects and multi-layer edits effortlessly. In fact, the intro to this very video was edited on this PC. Compared to my 2024 MacBook M3, the G7 Ti matched or exceeded performance in rendering and multi-layer grading tasks. For creators needing serious power without the premium price of a Mac, this PC is an excellent choice. Let's talk cooling. Despite the i9's reputation for running hot, Minisforum cooling design ensures the G7 Ti remains cool under pressure. Equipped with dual fans, 5 heat pipes and optimized airflow, the system performs consistently even during marathon gaming or editing sessions. Under heavy load, vent temperatures stayed between 30 to 35 Celsius, with fan noise peaking at a modest 50 decibels in gaming mode. So why settle for a console when a compact PC like AtomMan G7 Ti does it all? This isn't just for gamers, it doubles as a reliable content creating tool, excelling in demanding creative workloads. Future-proof features like Wi-Fi 7 and PCIe 4.0 keep it ready for the long haul. While its thermals and GPU power don't quite match the full-size desktops, the efficient cooling system ensures stable and quiet performance. So whether you're gaming, creating or multitasking, the G7 Ti truly delivers. Sure, it's pricier than consoles like PS5, but with versatility as a gaming rig, workstation and media hub, it's well worth considering. If you want to learn more, check out the links in the description. And a quick disclosure, I bought this PC myself, no sponsorships, no freebies. Every test and opinion comes from real-world use. I'll be keeping this PC as a benchmark for our future reviews. If you found this video helpful, drop a like or hit subscribe. It really makes our day. This channel is all about no-nonsense tech reviews powered by you. As long as you're watching, we'll keep making them.
Thanks for sticking around. I'll see you in the next one.